Hello, Chris. Thanks for joining us today.
Pleasure. Hi, thanks for inviting me. Thank you.
Your work as an estate agent takes up a huge amount of time. How do you actually manage to fit in being the president of the association as well?
Well, it's a juggling act, but we manage it. We get together every 6 weeks or so. There's always another event coming up, but and we enjoy it too, so yeah, we pack it in.
Are you actually the 130th president?
130th. We've been going a long time.
Wow, that's quite extraordinary. Yeah.
That's a lot, isn't it?
Yes.
What are the motivations of the association these days? I mean, it has changed over the years.
Yes, it's had to change. We're there to raise standards. And recently we've had long discussions about its future direction. Mm. And it's still there to raise standards, but we're having a real push on training. So we're running regular seminars, quarterly seminars. We're in discussions with Brighton City College at the moment about getting a certificated course, 2-year course off the ground. That would be great if we can get that done. And then the association can also help with lectures for that course, mm-hmm. but also as some sort of employment liaison. There's an issue with recruitment in the state
agency.
What
kind of courses are there?
Well, at the moment it's not. That's the issue.
Okay.
It isn't regulated in any way, is it? And there are no actual qualifications. Although there are for lettings, I know.
Yes, but a lot of the people that we know within our business have just kind of fallen into it somehow. And with trainees, we were looking to bring in trainees, but very often you have to. There's a lot of technical knowledge that's needed, and they very often have to sort of put in the back office for 6 months before you can really let them loose. A course like this would really be a game changer for our industry, and we're looking forward to trying to work with the City College on that.
Oh. Training is one thread of what you're doing, of course, and the standards that you're trying to maintain and in fact improve, but there's also a charitable element to the association.
Yes, there is, we're very keen to keep it local. We're raising money at the moment for the Clock Tower Sanctuary. I first heard about the Clock Tower Sanctuary through the Church of the Good Shepherd. We went and met with them. They do amazing work for our city's young homeless people, we're continuing that. After my year, we've got Paul from Paul Taggart from Hamptons. Will currently the vice president. He's coming in next year. Mm. He intends to continue with that. And we've got a few other events running through the year to raise money. We've got a volleyball tournament. We have quiz nights.
Wow.
And we have our annual dinner as well.
It sounds like you do amazing community work.
It's the scary association quiz nights. I've been to one of those, and they're really good fun.
Yeah.
They're really good fun. I love the fact that the association, of which I am an associate member, I love the fact that you do so much within the city for charity, but also raising the standards of our industry, and I think that's very, very valid, very valuable. And thank you so much for the work
thank
that you.
You
all do.
My
and
pleasure.
Thank you for joining us here at Lacey Stones Live today.
My pleasure.